Greetings, Jedi Knights and Sith Lords, and welcome to Star Wars Artefacts. My name is Dominic, aka Lord Doom, and today we will be reviewing Cybercraft's Death Trooper helmet, as seen in the Rogue One movies, as well as in The Mandalorian and the Andor series. The Death Trooper helmet is made by a company named Cybercraft. On their website, it is sold for about $385 US or $515 Canadian. You will also need to add about $100 to cover the shipping and another $100 to pay the custom fees. So it is a costly purchase. Enough talking, let's start the review. Obviously, there are no bugs with pretty images, since the helmet is not under official license. So, we will focus our attention on the helmet right away. The paint application is extremely well done and corresponds to the quality advertised on the company's website. The black lustered finish perfectly matches what can be seen in medias where Death Troopers appear. In universe, the trooper's armor is sprayed with a polymer called Reflect. This makes troopers harder to detect by electromagnetic sensors and well suited for stealth operations. On the front, we have two green tinted lenses. For the soldiers, it is an integrated multi-frequency targeting and acquisition sensor system. Above the lenses, we have a black matte plastic band that goes from one side of the helmet to the other. In the middle, we have a grill that covers the portion of the nose to the chin. On each side, we have two oval shapes that are image intensifying active pulse emitters. They light up when you press the little button located inside the helmet on the portion located behind the mount. However, I would have wished that the green plastic located in front of the LED lights had been less translucent in order to diffuse the light a little bit better. Before we continue analyzing the helmet, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, and smash the like button to help me continue my work. You can also follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. All the links are available in the description below. On the left side, we have a gray section that has 7 slots. Around the ear section, we have a NeuroSav micro-motion monitor. It is also the place where you will find a 3rd LED light. The right side features different details. The back of the helmet features embossed sections around the neck level. Each portion is made with a black matte plastic finish. The rest of the helmet has a lustered finish. The interior features a good quality black felt finish. As you can see on this image, it is also the place where you can turn on the LED lights or change the 3-volt battery. A black rubber gasket gives the helmet a great finish. Personally, I like to expose my helmet next to the wooden Stormtrooper doll I bought at the Tordarian Toymaker stall on Batuu at Galaxy's Edge. In the end, I'm very happy I was able to add this helmet to my collection. I had an eye on this one for a while, but the cost was just too high for me to pull the trigger. Luckily, my friend Mike decided to part ways with his and made me an offer I simply couldn't refuse. So, I will obviously cherish this piece for a long, long time. Now is the time to let me know what you think of this helmet. Do you think Cybercraft did a good job? Let me know in the comment section below. If you like my content, feel free to share it on your social media. I'll see you next week for another review, and until then, may the Force be with you, always.
Remember, The Force will be with you, always.